Boys, I am absolutely dialed right now.
I'm so ready for this shit. Fighting Demons, the album, finally out. We're gonna jump right into it. First song, Burn, and this has a music video, so let's go. Metro? Oh, that's sick, dude. Like, I like how this video, he's performing a song in this clip. I like the song, you know, how it's kind of building up as the intro. Yeah, this is sick, bro. I already know that's just gonna hit later. Very, very interesting. Kind of just a dark, just chill song, you know what I'm saying, to open up. I like that one a lot. I love that the footage of Juice was him performing the song, you know what I'm saying, probably when he was making it. And then we got track two, Already Dead, single.
Voices in my head, all I can hear them say, bitch, I'm already dead. I've been dead for years. I've been taking medicine again.
I just wanted to vibe out to that one, you know what I'm saying? Gotta listen to the album in order, but we're gonna move on to track three, You Wouldn't Understand.
You don't understand about me is I never gave a fuck about a goddamn thing. All I know is guns and sex, drugs, and crap. Told your bitch to get on her knees and suck the dick right.
Whoa! I did not expect like a hype Juice song. The beat is like almost giving me Conversations vibes, but it's definitely a little bit different. And the ski mask, water. Second verse, he's just talking about some freestyle shit. I don't spit writtens. Just rhyming off of that. He's talking about his favorite artists he listened to or who he's inspired by. Just completely random shit. I just know he got done hanging out with Ski Mask that day. Track 4 already came out, Wanted to LA with Justin Bieber. I think this is another solid song, kind of a pop song.
I wanted to LA.
Man, that song is catchy as fuck. I reacted to both Already Dead and Wanted to LA, so I'll make sure to link those videos, so if you want to go watch that, you can. But for that first leg of songs, Burn is probably my favorite, or Wanted to LA. We're moving to the skit, track 5, Eminem speaks.
People tried to tell me that I had a problem. I would say, get that fucking person out of here. I can't believe they said that shit to me. They know nothing about my fucking life, or they had a fucking mind. Taking things that people are giving you that you don't even know what the fuck they are. They look like a pill, and they're shaped like something that you take, so you take it.
I don't know if that was like something that they interviewed Eminem for, if that was kind of like already out as an interview. You know, like Juice's music helped a lot of people and really like spreads this message. So, you know, they're trying to use it and try to get, you know, artists like Justin Bieber, Eminem, etc., who went through the same things, you know, Juice might have gone through, and had them tell their story on this album. So I like that, and I like how they're pushing the message of that, and that's kind of like part of the theme that they're going for. So track 6, let's get back to the bangers. Rockstar in his prime. What's this building up to here? I guess the song, like, lyrically and stuff is, like, perfect to put after, you know, what we just heard. And the beat drop on the song was pretty sick.
I can't deal with this hurt on my own eye. Can I deal with this hurt?
So, like, one thing I'm noticing is, like, the production is not what I expected. But that was something that I was really, really interested to see going into this album. We're gonna move on to the next one, track 7, Doom.
There's a room full of toxic people, but it feels like it's just me and her in the room. I'd rather me die before she's sober.
like that part where like his voice is like doubled and he's saying the word doom. That shit sounds clean. Hopefully I don't like come off as boring on this album reaction, but that one was more just about like a toxic girl and he's like, bitch, my shoes cost your car. This next one, Go Hard. I'm most excited for this one here. Let's go. Oh, the beat. Oh, oh fuck. Pay for you, I go hard. Bro, that beat, like I got chills on the intro, man. This song is sick. I know it's short and like it kind of, you know, took a second to get going. The song is so weird, dude. All these songs are so weird. I don't know how to describe it. You can kind of hear like the rain in the background. I'm excited to hear that with headphones on. And I saw your face and I heard your name. Gotta make you my babe. Put that on the gang gang. It's like a just completely different Juice style. Like Go Hard sounds nothing like anything off Legend Never Die. I feel like Legend Never Die was again kind of that emo rap Juice, you know what I'm saying, for the most part, while this is more I don't really know what you call some of Juice's music, if we're being honest. You get what I'm saying? Like how that was like the more typical Juice style compared to this is just a, I don't even know what I want to call it, but this Juice style, the fighting demon style, like that's how they're different. That's what I was trying to say earlier.
I also make music talking about certain subjects because I know that I'm not the only one going through, you know, what's happening. Me talking about certain things can help somebody else through what they're going through, as well as me trying to figure it out myself.
I sound like a nerd, but I know exactly what interview clip this is from. It's from before Death Race for Love. Juice was just like 100% honest with his music. And you know, what he's saying is like, what I'm going through can help other people, which it has, clearly. So that's just like the theme of this album, you know what I'm saying? I get it now. I get what this album's going for. So now we're on the second half of the album. The next song is called Not Enough. Now I've been drowning in this liquor bottle, but drowning's not enough. They tell me that I won't ever see tomorrow, but I don't give a fuck. I'm running out of patience, out of play. Goodbye. This motherfucker was the GOAT, alright? Now I've been drowning in this liquor bottle, but drowning's not enough. They tell me that I won't ever see tomorrow, but I don't give a fuck. You know, there is times when I'm listening to Juice and you sometimes just need a happy pop song. I really mess with his style and whoever produced this did a great job. He did a Chicago like show for Juice tonight, had like a ton of people perform. They played the album for everybody in the stadium. Not gonna lie, I turned that on after I got home from work and Ski Mask was performing there saying some words, and I'm not gonna lie, I cried. I did. I can't wait to like just watch my own video back. This is like already one of my favorite videos I've ever made, not gonna lie. Track 11, we got an interesting one. Feline featuring Polo G and Trippy Red. Got a new nine, better leave your mouth wide. Leave you hug tied, burning on a campfire. Chopper hit him with a force like I'm Obi-Wan Kenobi. Chopper hit him with the force, Obi-Wan Kenobi. Your boyfriend still on the porch, he ain't in the field yet. Them guns black, don't hit and run, you get your grill wrecked. Got a new nine, better leave your mouth wide. Leave you hog tied, burning on a campfire. Before I leave the crib, I pray to God I won't die. I know it's hard to kill me, but I know they gon' try. You's a pussy boy, yeah, you a feline. In a dream world, rolling with your dream girl. Say she love you, but she won't let me, she a fiend girl. They leave my boy Trippy last verse because it was the best verse. I'm pretty sure this is just like an old Juice song with Polo G and Trippy features on it, but Trippy killed it, bro. I just felt like he showed more character. Rap Caviar is gonna have a field day with this song. Track 12, relocate.
He did a lot of really nice, generous things for me. Like, he bought me a house, and, you know, cars, and
this is his
paid off my student loans, and, you know, all kinds of stuff. But he, I'm doing my own thing.
Interview of his mom talking about how Juice didn't really care, like he was just genuinely a nice person. And shit, his mom could probably buy 25 mansions right now. I think the thing throwing me off on this album is I expected more songs to be like already dead. Got one more skit, the last one. It's Juice WRLD speaks.
I remember up in kindergarten, the teacher told me I wouldn't be shit. And then she saw me play the piano and made all the other kids seasick.
I always see like the memes. It's like did the teachers of these rappers actually say they weren't gonna be shit? And then you got Juice saying that his kindergarten teacher said he wouldn't be shit.
I feel like my hair sometimes a little dreadful. I grew up on rap heavy. Times I wanna take myself and break myself so I can reshape myself.
Sick. I like the beat in the background, so I recognize at the end, that's what they used for the Legends Never Die trailer. I guess that's from the same freestyle. That's like the full thing of it, which is cool because like I'll randomly kind of just think back to that freestyle. So now it's like actually on an album. All right, let's keep going. We got track 14, Until the Plug Comes Back Around.
Goes down, down, down when the plug is in town. My prescriptions fell and my pills get passed around. I'll come back around.
Yeah, that's sick. I love the singing part kind of into just whatever he's talking. I'm saying he said something about demons, so yeah, obviously fits on the album. And again, this is probably, these type of songs is probably what sparked like the whole album concept.
Down, 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 when the plug is in time.
15, From My Window. I know part of the chorus from a snippet or something, so I'm excited for this one.
Ecstasy, taking rock star steez.
Shit, bro, you know if he's like mumbling, he's warming up, and the song's gonna be a banger.
I see the world from my window. I ain't going outside, see it through my window. Money from the record label, spend it on ammo. Living in paranoia, got me living like I'm Rambo. Put it in her mouth, Juice WRLD pops.
Okay. They like blocked out the word dick. Put it in her mouth, Juice WRLD popsicle? I get what that means, and that is next level horny.
It all started with three Zans. Switched up to the perks, committed trees, and now it's XO.
Was this motherfucker so good? Like, what? The end of that verse back in the hook was the best part of the song, dude. That was God.
From the record label, spend it all ammo. Living in paranoia, got me living like a Rambo.
Again, back to that kind of emo rap vibe. Like, he just doesn't miss. Like, he just owns that genre. Big moment here, boys. Track 16, Girl of My Dreams, featuring Suga from BTS. Now, this BTS feature is the funniest shit ever. And by the way, I'm on the side of the BTS feature, you know what I'm saying? Juice already collaborated with BTS. I don't know if Suga's gonna be speaking English. And Lil Bibby was smart. He posted a picture with this guy from BTS. He didn't post a picture with him in the studio with anyone else working on this album. And, you know, me and BTS stans, dap me up right now. If you BTS fan, you click on this video, I love you.
Both of your legs gone away, you falling for me. The same way that the rain falls.
It's reminding me of Desire. That's what it was. Wait. There's definitely more than four oceans. Wait, there's Pacific, Atlantic, Indian, Arctic. Is there one more or is there four oceans? That'd be a funny moment if I'm wrong. Oh, the singing.
You're out of me.
back, I don't drop that track, I'm never hey. I ain't gonna lie, you got it all of me.
Oh, fuck, man. Juice on a love song like that. Singing again was crazy on that. Come and Go with Marshmello went number two. Lucid Dreams went number two. This song with BTS, if this goes number two, I'm deleting my channel. Track 17, Feel Alone. Now, I was not aware how deadly this snippet was. This is like the fan favorite snippet right now that everyone wanted. So it made the album.
Stuck in my mind, oh yeah. I'm in my prime, oh yeah. Taking my time, oh yeah. Even though everything feels so fast. There's times when I feel alone. There's times when I feel alone.
This motherfucker was, oh man, he was so right. He was in his prime, wasn't he? I would say lived up to the hype. That chorus is insane. I feel like just bumping that one in the car. You know what I'm saying? You're just rapping every single bar. Last one. This has been such an interesting album. But I think the coolest part about this album, listening to it, is it's just not what I expected. The typical Juice WRLD style from 2018, 2019. That's what the music's always gonna sound like. It's not gonna progress into whatever music sounds like in 2025. What I like about this album is it's almost like Juice was here making this new style of music. This album doesn't sound like Legends Never Die, or it doesn't sound like Goodbye and Good Riddance. You know what I'm saying? Let's get into the last one, track 18, My Life in a Nutshell.
This is my life in a nutshell. They know me for my talent, but don't know how my pain feels.
Yeah, this song lyrically just wraps up everything that was talked about in this album.
Descriptions that I feel never made the pain heal.
Alright, so I guess I gotta give a little review here at the end. Yeah, Fighting Demons, second posthumous album from Juice. I think my favorite songs are definitely Burn, definitely Go Hard, Not Enough, From My Window, Girl of My Dreams, Feel Alone. So those are like my top songs that we just listened to. Maybe we can make a video comparing it to Legends Never Die or seeing which one's better. But my next video is going to be a tier list on it. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this video. It's gonna be a longer album reaction. I really like this video. I really do. Like this one, this video means a lot to me. I really enjoy this album. I'm gonna give more thoughts on it throughout the week. Follow me over on Twitter. If you guys liked my album reaction, I have a ton of other album reactions to check out, a ton of other great videos. So you guys should go ahead and check out my channel. So yeah, subscribe. Make sure you guys give me a thumbs up on this video. Peace out, everyone. Thank you for watching.